In this video, you'll learn how to configure conversions in GA4, Google Analytics 4. It's important to take the time to do this because conversions are used to measure the most important actions taking place on your website. For example, you might want to track people completing a form, signing up for a newsletter, or making a purchase. In this video, we're going to walk through two ways to configure conversions. We're going to walk through the steps to create an event in Google Analytics, and we're also going to cover how we can use Google Tag Manager. It's important to highlight that we track conversions using key events in Google Analytics. So when you jump into your reports, you'll be using key events to understand if people convert on your website. Okay, let's get started. We're looking at my GA4 demo property, so let's navigate to Admin. And let's select Data Display and choose Events. We're currently looking at the Key Events tab. This shows us all of the events that have already been configured to track conversion actions taking place on our website. If you want to configure another event as a key event, we can select the Recent Events tab. We're now looking at all of the events that have been recently collected into our GA4 property. And on the left, we can see there's a column of stars. When a star is solid gray and not just an outline, this tells us the event has been marked as a key event to report on conversions. So if you look down the list of recent events and you see the event you want to use for your conversion, you can mark it as a key event. To do this, we just need to click the star. In order to be able to mark events as key events, you will need editor or administrator permission for the property. If you don't have the correct permission, you will need to get someone who does to configure things for you, or have your permission increased. Since I do have the correct level of permission for this property, this event is now marked as a key event. Now, moving forward, whenever this event is collected, it will be counted as a key event. So, if you see the event you want to track as a conversion, this is fine, but there will be times when you don't see the event listed. Or, what if you want to track a particular page, like a thank you page, as a conversion? In this case, we can't just mark the page view event as a key event because this would mean every page people view on our website would be counted as a conversion. This means if you want to track something more specific, like people viewing a thank you page, we need to create a new event first. Now we're going to cover the steps to create a new event directly inside Google Analytics. This allows us to create an event based on one that has already been collected. And this is a great option if you want to track people viewing a particular thank you page as a key event. We're still looking at the events settings in the GA4 property, and we can see there's a button at the top to create a new event. Let's click this. To start, we need to name our new event. I'm going to name my event Generate_Lead. This is one of Google's recommended event names, and it's perfect for tracking when people have successfully submitted a form on our website. Next, we can enable the Mark as Key Event option. This will mean that as soon as our new event is triggered, it will be counted as a key event. We can now define a value for our key event. For my key event, I'm going to leave US dollars selected, and I'm going to set the value of the conversion to 50. This means the event will be assigned a value of $50 each time it's triggered. Below this, we can control how the key event will be counted. The default is once per event, which means each time the event is triggered, it will be counted as a key event. However, we can change this to once per session, which is useful if you expect people to complete the same action multiple times, but you're not increasing the total value for your business or organization. I'm going to leave the default for my event, but you can change this. Scrolling down, let's ensure the Create Without Code option is enabled. We also need to check that the correct data stream is selected. In most cases, you'll only have one data stream if you're just tracking your website, so you probably won't need to change this. Next, we need to define the conditions for when we want our new event to be triggered. Google has made it easy for us to create a new event based on a page being viewed on our website. We can see the page view event is already selected for us. Using this simplified setup, we can see there's only one matching option, which is URL contains. So you can then enter the URL or the part of the URL we want to match below this. Let's enter thank-you. This means our new event will trigger every time someone views a page on our website that has a URL containing thank-you. I'm happy with the configuration for this event, so let's click Create at the top. We've now created a new event that will be triggered when someone views a thank you page on our website. Once someone has viewed a page that matches our condition, you'll be able to see the event in the real-time reports straight away. However, it can take 12 to 24 hours for key events to appear in the standard reports. So if someone visits the thank you page now, I recommend checking back tomorrow to see it in your reports. And if you're wondering, you can enable up to 30 unique events as key events in GA4. So you should have plenty of scope to track all of those important actions as conversions. To check this, you can click Quota Information on the top right-hand corner. And this shows you how many key events you've created. Okay, let's close this, and now let's take a look at where you can see key events reported in Google Analytics. Let's navigate to Reports. And let's select Acquisition and open the Traffic Acquisition Report. I previously configured key events in my demo property, so I already have data in my reports. If you've only just configured key events, you'll need to wait until the event has been triggered before you begin to see it in your reports. If we scroll to the right of the table, we can see the total number of key events that have been triggered and the session key event rate. You can also use the drop-down to select an individual key event to update the metrics. Apart from this report, which includes key events by default, you can also add the key events metrics to your other reports, and you can add them to exploration reports. We've now covered the steps to create a new key event in GA4 based on an existing event. But what if you want to track a custom action as a key event? In this case, using Google Tag Manager is a great way to send the event to GA4. Let's head to Google Tag Manager. We can see there's an existing Google tag in this GTM container. This tag will automatically send events, including page views, to Google Analytics. So now we need to create a new tag to send an additional event for the conversion we want to track. To do this, let's create a new tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4 Conversion. Now let's select Tag Configuration. And let's choose Google Analytics and select GA4 Event as the tag type. We need to enter our measurement ID from Google Analytics. I've already created a variable for my measurement ID, so I'm going to select this. If you'd like to learn the steps to create your own variable, then please check out the extra resources and my courses in the description below this video. Okay, now let's name the event Generate_Lead. You can add event parameters to send extra information with your event. For example, if you wanted to distinguish different types of leads. But for this event, I'm going to keep things simple and I'm going to leave the defaults. So let's select Triggering. And now we need to create a new trigger that will only fire our GA4 event tag when someone views a thank you page on our website. let's click the blue plus sign. Let's name our trigger Any Thank You page. And let's select Trigger Configuration. You can create triggers for any action you'd like, but we're going to create a trigger that fires the tag based on the URL of the page someone is viewing on our website. So let's select Initialization. And then Some Initialization Events. Now I'm going to select Page URL. Contains. And I'm going to enter thank-you. This will mean that our tag is triggered whenever someone views a page that contains thank-you in the URL. Now let's click Save. And let's save the tag. You can now preview the changes to test them on your website, but I'm happy with the new tag, so I'm going to publish the changes to my website. To do this, we click Submit. We name our version. And click Publish. You can apply the same technique to any other actions you want to track as key events in Google Analytics. The main thing is that you need to create a trigger that will fire the GA4 event tag once someone has completed your desired action. So this could be submitting a form, it could be clicking a button, viewing a page, or any other action you choose. Now that we've published our changes in Google Tag Manager, we can head back to Google Analytics. And you will then need to enable the event as a key event. To do this, we can follow the steps we covered previously, so we navigate to Admin. Select Data Display, and then Events. If your key event has already been collected, you'll find it under the Recent Events tab. If it hasn't been collected yet, you won't find it here, so instead, you can pre-configure the event as a key event. To do this, click Create Event. Enter the name of the event exactly as it will be sent to Google Analytics. So the exact event name you used in Google Tag Manager. Then enable the Mark as Key Event option. Scroll down and select Create with Code. Now you can click Create. Once the event has been collected, it will appear as a key event in your reports. We've now looked at two ways to create key events to report on conversions in GA4. We've covered creating events directly in Google Analytics and using Google Tag Manager. For each conversion you want to track as a key event, you only need to choose one of these methods. What conversions are you going to track in Google Analytics? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.